there. Welcome to the Butlin's Storybook Pantomime. Please remember to turn off your mobile phones during the show, or else we'll set the wicked queen on you. Now, sit back, relax and enjoy the tale of Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Thank you. everyone for your lovely birthday wishes. You're all invited to my birthday party. Oh, but I do need to find that Dotty so I can get everything ready. Well, I wonder where she is. Oh, come on, everybody. Will you help me find her? Yes. Oh, there's Dotty. Where are you? There's Dotty.
That's safe, my darling. Yeah, no problem. I'm Julie. And I guess they need a seat. Thank you, Ben.
Oh! Well, I wasn't expecting to see all of you here. Hello! Well, boys and girls, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Nurse Dorothy, but all my friends call me Dotty. I do all the cooking, all the cleaning here in the castle, and I'm nanny to the beautiful Snow White. Oh, she's lovely, and she's got so many friends. I've got an idea. Will you all be my friends? You will? Oh, brilliant. Right, well, any time I come out on stage, I'm going to shout out, Killy! And you're going to shout back, Killy! Can you do that? You can, right, brilliant. Well, have a bit of a practice with your eye ready. Here we go. Killy! Have you done it yet? Right, you're going to be 10 times louder. We'll try it again really, really loud. Here we go. Killy! Oh, he's doing the acid mountain. But you know what? I'm a bit sad today. Come on, it's sadder than that. I'm sad because I'm a widow. Yes, I'm referring to my late husband, William. That's right. I've lost my Willy. But anyway, I want to look out for a man today. So let's have a little look. Oh, you're a lovely looking young man, aren't you? Don't look behind you. You with a tablet in your hand. What's your name, babes?
Colin.
Alan.
Colin.
Colin. All right, darling, calm down. I'm only talking. Colin, do me a favour, babes. Stand up for me. You wish you had that tablet now, wouldn't you, Colin? Now, Colin, you weren't really joining in on the Queens, were you? No, you weren't.
Too busy drinking.
Too busy playing Angry Birds, weren't you? Oh, Candy Crush. I hate that. I hate Candy Crush, anyway. Now, Colin, we're going to do it just me and you. I'm going to come out, cooey, and you're going to say it back. Now, Colin, forget about the thousands of people watching. Forget about the spotlight, babes. It's just me and you. Come on, Colin. Cooey!
Cooey!
Give Colin a big clap, will you? Just sit down, babes. Colin, stop looking at me. Stop looking at me! I know I'm irresistible, but calm it down. I'm a human. You can't stop looking at me. Stay with me. Be what I be. You can't stop looking at me. So get out of my face. You can't stop. Tell you about me. Tell you about me. Be what I be. You can't stop looking at me. My target is Jimmy.
Yeah.
am happy. Everything would be just perfect if it wasn't for...
that wicked stepmother of yours. Boys and girls, she's a really, really wicked woman.
Dorothy, I don't know why she'd like to be so much.
You know,
she doesn't even wish me happy birthday.
I know why.
Mum!
Shh! Nicole. She's jealous of you, that's right.
Jealous?
Well, look at you. You're so beautiful. She used to be the most beautiful woman in all of Ruritania before you were born. I don't know why your father ever married her after your mother died. Come on, then. Sounds like Jason and our wicked stepmother coming.
Courtiers of Ruritania, Her Gracious Majesty Queen Esmeralda bids me to announce that soon we will expect a visit from Prince Paul of the Faraway Kingdom. O.M.G. During his visit, the royal apartment in which he will be staying will remain strictly off-limits to all ladies of the court. Is that clearly understood?
Yes, Jason.
The Prince of Her Majesty Queen Esmeralda!
I hope you all understood Jason's address.
Well, I didn't know his address. What rooms again?
Order. I decree they'll be sent to the castle dungeons and starved until they're dead for mercy. Now they all leave, except the Princess Snow White, if you want to speak. Come here, Snow White. Now tell me, what's all that noise I could hear going on so early this morning when I was trying to sleep?
Oh, I'm sorry, Your Majesty. We're just getting excited about my birthday.
Oh, yes, of course, my dear. Today's your birthday. Many happy returns of the day. I take you to a party.
A party? For me? Oh, yes, please, Your Majesty.
Oh, I can just see it now. A beautiful marquee full of flowers and candles. An appearance from One Direction. You and all your little friends can dance the night away, drinking Red Bull from crystal tumblers.
Would you like that, my dear?
More than anything else, stepmother.
Well,
come! I'm not made of money! Expensive parties. You need to learn your place, my girl. I find your behavior distasteful and unbecoming for the Princess of Ruritania. You need to learn some manners and respect, and I will see that you do. Now go to your bedroom!
Oh, yes, Your Majesty.
And it's nice to meet you all. I live here in the castle with my mum, Dotty. Would you lot like to be in my gang? Yeah. Pardon? Yeah. Oh, brilliant. Well, I tell you what, how about every time I shout out, "Hi, boys and girls," you lot shout back, "Watcher, mate, can you do that for me?" Yeah. Oh, come on. I said, "Can you do that for me?" Tell you what, let's have a quick practice. Ready? Hiya, boys and girls. Ah, oh, that was absolutely rubbish. And I know you can do so much better, so we'll give it another go. Ready? Hiya, boys and girls. Ah, oh, that was brilliant. Have you lot met Snow White yet? Oh, isn't she beautiful? But that wicked queen has always been really nasty to her.
Well, I hate to see her upset, because, well, she's my best friend. Can I tell you a little secret? I think I'm in love with her. Oh, she sends me. She really sends me. Sends you, Muddle. The wicked queen, she sends me a far and wide image of a mum pack for sandwiches and a road map.
Oh, she's been hard on you as well, has she?
Yeah, she's rotten, she is. Rotten. Do you know what I feel like doing? Putting itching powder in her knickers.
Oh, Muddle, don't be ridiculous. Although, most of the time, she does make me feel so depressed.
Oh. Well, I've heard that you can cure that by sticking needles in your ears. What's it called again? Acapulco.
Oh, acupuncture.
Bless you.
Silly Muddle.
I know. I was only trying to make you smile. But do you know what? If I was a prince, I'd marry you.
Oh, Muddles. I could marry you even if you were a prince.
Oh, yeah? Why's that?
Because I don't love you in that way, but one day I'll meet the prince of my dreams and we'll fall in love and we'll marry and we'll live in a beautiful palace.
Oh, yeah?
With marble floors and silk curtains.
Oh, yeah?
And beautiful crystal chandeliers.
Oh, yeah? You mean you're going to live at Pontins?
Oh, Muddles.
I know I couldn't marry you. What have you been a royal princess and all? Besides, everyone always says I'm clumsy and messy and stupid.
Oh, Muddles, you're not clumsy and messy.
Thanks.
Don't be silly, Muddles, you know. You're my best friend.
Aww. Stupid, and I may sound stupid, and I may act stupid, but don't let that fool you.
What? Why?
Because I am stupid.
Yes, you are stupid, you insolent wretch! Get it off from you, and you will suffer a fate worse than death.
Oh, no! You're not going to make me watch the Only Way is Essex again, are you?
There'll be no party.
But you're a princess.
Not anymore.
But you're more royal than she is.
Apparently not, but if I can't change it, might as well make the best of it.
I'm sure Her Majesty will be delighted to welcome you, Your Highness. Although, some warning of an exact time of your arrival would have been appreciated. Please relay my apologies, my good man.
I'm not sure the Queen is ready to receive you. She's still in her throne room.
She's still on the throne, more like.
I can wait.
Why don't you go tell the Queen if it's alive or in, I'll look after the Prince.
Yes, that probably is the best course of action. If you would care, Lydia, I will inform the Queen.
I'll be most obliged.
Hiya, boys and girls. Oh, sorry. I didn't know we had visitors.
Muddles! This is Prince Paul of the Faraway Kingdoms.
Oh, your majesticals.
So what are you doing so far from the Faraway Kingdoms, if you don't mind me asking?
Matters of state, my lady. My father, the king, insisted I find a bride before he dies.
Huh. Well, is he not well then?
No, he's in perfect health, but he longs for an heir.
Oh, he's bald.
My father wishes me to form an alliance with one of the smaller kingdoms this side of the Great Forest. I was just passing and I...
Oh, I'm there! I'm forgetting myself. You've been going up and down on that saddle all day. Your bum must be like a pack of broken off knobs.
No, madame. I came by the coach of horses.
Oh, he's been to the pub.
Cup of tea? What an excellent idea. Excuse me, miss. Could you please bring me some refreshments?
She isn't a servant, Your Highness. She's
a kitchen maid.
Please forgive me if you do not look like a kitchen maid.
Oh, and how is a kitchen maid supposed to look?
I don't know. I just...
Never judge a book by its cover, Your Highness.
No, you don't understand. She...
Will you be quiet? She knows what she's doing.
Excuse me.
Her Majesty has agreed to grant you an audience immediately.
Oh, well, he each and have an audience with her, but I wouldn't mind recalling.
I was just asking this
immediately, Prince.
Yes, yes, of course.
Did you see the way she looked at him?
I know.
And did you see the way he looked at her?
I know. It's funny, I was only saying to Snow White the other day when she was getting her photographs from Photo Call and they weren't there.
Well, what did you say?
Someday your prince will come.
Well, I hope a prince does come.
Well, we all deserve a bit of good luck occasionally. And sometimes, well, I get really fed up.
Oh, well, don't worry, Muddles. I'll always be here to cheer you up.
Aw, thanks,
Mum. I'd like to go to see Crabby Mouse.
Where's that music coming from?
When the world leaves you feeling blue, you can count on me. I will be there for you when it seems all your hopes and dreams are a million miles away. I will reassure you. We got something together. Good friends to live on each other. Never fear for death and heart. I got you and you got me. Every mountain I have reached for the stars. Follow your heart's desire, reach for the stars. And when that rainbow shining over you, shining, that friendly dream shining through.
I'm saying like a dance move.
Don't believe in knowing you be tall.
I think there's only time.
Sky's the limit, you can reach a goal. No one knows just what future holds. And nothing you can be is a hard as it be.
I said reach,
right now you know.
Oh, reach out, reach for the moon.
Reach, follow that rainbow.
Oh, lovely, and your dreams will all come true. Climb every mountain higher, reach for the stars. Follow your heart's desire, reach for the stars. And when every moon's shining over you, that's when the dreams will all come true.
A beautiful, rich, middle like you. He'll be adorable.
How do I look?
Enchanting.
His Royal Highness, Prince Paul of the Faraway Kingdom.
Your Majesty, I am your humble servant.
Oh, my! Arrived, Prince Paul. Now tell me, what brings you to our little kingdom?
My father wishes for me to find a bride.
And you heard the tales of the legendary beauty.
Indeed, Your Majesty. Today I have found her.
My goodness! Don't waste any time, do you?
Excuse me.
How dare you interrupt me while I'm entertaining?
Your Highness, I did ask this girl to bring me some refreshments. Thank you.
My pleasure, Your Highness.
Beat it, little skinny two shoes. Get out!
Your Majesty, I am overcome by such beauty.
Of course you are.
Well, at long last, I have found the girl of my dreams.
Oh, really? already know.
That beautiful girl who brought me my tea. What is her name?
You mean Snow White?
Ah, Snow White. What a beautiful name. Your Majesty, might I ask your permission for Snow White to marry me?
Snow White? To marry you? Oh, well, yes. Of course you have my consent. Now, return to your camp in the forest. I'll have the girl brought to you immediately.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
So, he wants Snow White more than me. Surely you all know that I am the most beautiful woman in the whole kingdom.
Since she's grown, Snow White is now the fairest in the land.
He informs me that Snow White is to join him.
Excellent. Now listen carefully, Jason. Have a little plan. Tomorrow, Snow White will go on a journey, a long journey, and you will accompany her. I want you to take the old road out of the city.
But, Your Majesty, that road leads through a dark and dismal forest.
I know. So much better than a bright, sunny, open space, don't you think?
Why?
Because, Jason, somewhere dark and dismal, it's perfect for you to do the dirty deeds.
I don't understand, Your Majesty.
Take Snow White and...
I'm afraid you've lost me.
Come on, you fool!
Kill her?
Yes, and so I know you've done it. Are we to bring our heart back in a casket?
Your Majesty, I cannot commit such a crime.
You can, Jason. And you will. You have a family, don't you? A wife and children?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Then see that it is done, and now comes to no harm. However, disobey me, and you will regret it for the rest of your life.
How can you be so evil?
It's a gift. Now, tell no one about our arrangement. See that your lips are sealed.
My lips are sealed, Your Majesty.
Good. Now leave.
Yes, Your Majesty. Come on, Snow White. You're lagging behind again.
I'm sorry, Jason. I'm just so tired and thirsty. Could I just stop just for a little while to have a drink?
No, Snow White. I'm afraid. You won't be needing a drink.
Why? What do you mean, Jason? Oh, Jason, what are you doing?
I've been instructed to kill you.
Kill me? But why?
On the Queen's command. Jealous of you. Jealous of your beauty.
Oh, no, but Jason, please don't kill me. I beg you.
I don't think I could kill you, Princess. But if I don't, then my family will surely suffer. There's only one thing for it. I shall have to pretend that you are dead.
That means I shall have to leave you here in the forest until I can find a safe place for you to stay.
Thank you, Jason. I'm so frightened to stay here in the forest all alone.
You will have to be brave. Now, I must leave before nightfall. Take care, Princess. I will be back.
Oh, Jason, come back. Come back! 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 Back!
It's a good start to a scene, isn't it? You know what?
No!
We'll do it later. Carry on.
Titan models! Have you got all your chores?
What chores?
I'll have a Guinness!
Right, well, what are we going to do now then, Mum?
Well, first things first, you need to get me out of this carpet by here.
This one.
I've got to be careful here now. Here we go. Lovely. Come on, quick. Now then, models. What's going to happen is, when the Queen's finished her lunch upstairs, her plates come sliding down these two chutes.
Really?
Yeah, they come sliding down, you give her a wipe, pass to me, and I'll pop it on the dresser.
Well, that sounds tricky.
It's really, really simple. All you need to remember is, bottom you, wipe me.
Bottom you, wipe me. Bottom me, wipe you. Bottom you, wipe my bottom.
No, you silly boy. I'll pop these on before they explode.
How do I look?
Cracking.
Well, you should have got a Specsavers, Mum.
And you must remember the signal.
The signal?
I show you. When you're at the bottom of the chute and you're good and ready, you shout out, okay! Plate comes down, you give it a wipe, pass to me, and I'll pop it on the dresser.
Wow! Can I have a go?
Of course you can.
Okay!
Plate comes down, you give it a wipe, pass it to me, and I'll pop it on the dresser.
Fantastic! And what's that chute for then?
Ah, now this chute is for the most valuable, expensive china. Now I'll look after this one, because I don't want you dropping one.
And what's the signal for that one then?
I show you. All right!
Ah, I see. So it's all right and okay.
Oh! But be careful. This is very expensive china, okay?
Okay.
Only say okay when you want a plate, and I
go! Okay. Oh.
Well done, models. You caught them all without breaking any. Everything's going to be all right. Now look what you've done. Now put them there before you break anything else.
All right.
Oh. Not until I'm ready!
Oh! Okey-dokey.
Now assume position.
Position assumed.
Not like that.
Oh, sorry. Hold on. This bit could get dangerous. Okay!
Alright.
Okay!
Alright.
Can't leave him on. Okay!
Alright!
Okay!
Disaster area. Now pass me the plates before you break anything else.
I'm ready, Mum! 1, 2, 3!
How's that?
Woo! Oh, hold on, sorry. We forgot one, Mum. This goes. with that set. Oh, ready, Mum! 1, 2, 3!
Now look what you've done!
Hey.
Now get there and don't say another word.
Okay, alright!
That unicorn.
He is. You on my kitchen.
You got a chip on your shoulder. Huh? Get out.
Silly boy, my.
Whatever shall I do? I've been wondering these things for hours, but there's still nobody here to help me. Your chance is having this party present, but I do wish you had left me here all alone. Oh, I wish someone was here to help me. Oh, I wish.
Courage, Snow White! Shed not one more tear! For in the woods where fairies live, you'll never need to fear.
Who are you?
I am Fairy Kindheart!
And have you come here to help me?
Well, that's the task I have been given.
I'm so glad. I was so frightened.
Then, Snow White, you must follow me. A moonlit forest glade you'll see, across oak and elm and sycamore, while flowers weave a carpet floor, past bluebell woods and copper beech, and very soon we both shall reach a tiny house on Primrose Hill, where 7 little friends do dwell. And there, on a tiny wooden bed, tonight you'll rest your weary head. On fairy power, now I'll call to summon creatures great and small. Frog, rabbit, fox, watch them roam. Come guide us to this